Morning everybody. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. As usual, I will check our attendance first
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
before we start the class, ya. Adenisa is not here, Almira is not here, Devriansa is not here. Deza? Yes.
Present, Miss.
Okay, kucingnya udah dikeluarin tadi Deza ya. Evin?
Yes, Miss.
Wadah. Faira? Oh my God. Hamdi? Jonanta?
Present, Miss. Present, Miss.
Maria Frisilia Simatupang, adiknya Immanuel Simatupang. Maria Katarina, not here. Novella Savitri. Patricia Rizky Amanda.
Present, Miss.
Rika Chania. Sandrina, ada
Present, Miss.
Siti Fatima Azahra, Fiska Febiola, Abai nggak ada, Apla, ada
Present, Miss.
Melani Karisma Putri nggak ada. Oke, okay. Buat menyingkat waktu, berhubung saya juga udah mulai goyang-goyang ini. Mungkin kita langsung mulai aja presentasinya. The presenters is Hamdi Wi and also Maria Frisilia Simatupang. Bentar. Saya coba ganti koneksi dulu ya. Koneksi saya yang ini hancur sekali kayaknya.
Merah sinyal nih.
Oke, okay.
Halo?
Apakah sinyal saya sudah lebih bagus di kalian? Tampaknya.
Iya.
Ya, kalau gitu kita mulai aja untuk Hamdi dan Maria. Siapa yang akan share screen-nya?
Hamdi, Miss. Wait, Miss.
Oke. Okay.
Wait
Miss
a second.
Yes, of course. Dan Hamdi. Wah, kalian kayak mau di kayak mau apa gitu ya berdua ini. Oke. Okay.
Wait, Miss, nge-lag, Miss.
Ya, nggak apa-apa. Take your time. Aduh, ya Allah. Oke. Okay. You can start when you are ready, ya. Yeah?
Ini kalau aku ngeliat gak sih? Tidak kelihatan ya fullnya.
Ada.
Tapi tidak full misalnya.
Kamu pas bagian share screen-nya, kamu itu dulu, kamu fullkan dulu, kemudian kamu pakai laptop ya?
Yes, Miss.
Nah, kamu fullkan dulu, kemudian kamu klik yang tanda Windows-nya itu, baru kamu ke Zoom-nya, baru share new screen lagi.
Oh,
Share
gitu.
screen
Wait.
tunjukin ke yang itu.
Oke,
Oh my God. I can't breathe ya. Aku sudah bisa nafas. Susah nafas ini.
Oke, ada.
Bisa.
Dah. Udah ya,
Okay.
bisa ya.
Alright, good.
Maria.
Okay. Good morning, everyone.
Morning.
Morning.
I am Maria, and my partner Handi will be presenting specific voice tense, simple future and past future. Next time. Next. The table of contents, one passive verb tense, simple future, two example, three passive verb tense and simple past future, for example, five conclusion. Next. Passive verb tense, simple future. Definition passive voice simple future tense. Passive voice simple future sentences are sentence object is doing work in the simple future tense. For example, the sentence I will take a fruit in there is changed in passive voice to a fruit will be the taken by me in there. Different from passive voice is form of verb where the subject of the sentence is the actor of the verb in the sentence. In active voice, the subject is the original actor or the of the action. The characteristic of belum, belum, belumnya.
Okay.
Oke. Belum aku bilang teks ya. The characteristic of passive verb tense simple future. One, the subject is passive because it's given treatment or action. Two, using the auxiliary verb will be followed by the verb three. Three, using the auxiliary verb be going to follow by the verb three. And the last, the predicator of the activity may or might not be named by agent. Formal passive voice, simple future. As or direct object plus will plus be plus past participle plus by. As plus am or is or are going. To plus B plus past participle belum handi by engine sabar ya the definition from one voice in passive voice the subject acts as the receiver of the action while the agent acts as the preparator of the action. The formula above applies to transitive verb where verbs are generally passive. Next. Example one. Positive passive Asian food is going to be cooked by mother. Mean passive Asian food is not going to be cooked by mother. Interrogative passive is Asian food going to be cooked by mother. Example two, first passive, the good job will be done by next week. Negative passive, the good job will not be done by next week. Interrogative passive, will the good job done by me next week. Example different active and passive voice. Active voice, Handy will write a novel on the weather. Passive-nya, a novel will be written by Handy on the weather. Next. Handy? Can you explain?
No.
Andi, kau jelasin. Nah.
Okay, sorry. The next dewek tadi, sorry.
Oke, go on.
Passive verb tense, simple past future. Definition of passive voice, simple future past tense. Passive voice is a sentence where the subject is subject to an action or activity. In Indonesian, passive voice is usually preceded by the affix prefix there or d. Passive voice is the opposite of active voice, which is a sentence where the subject performs an action or activity. Next, formula passive voice simple future past tense. Passive voice jenis passive positif. S plus word plus B plus verb plus be plus S plus was where plus going to be plus verb but three but plus but S plus word plus not plus B plus verb three but plus by S plus was where plus not plus going plus to be plus verb three plus but kalau in interrogative words plus s plus b plus verb three plus by was or where plus s plus going plus two plus b and plus verb three plus by. Next. Formula passive voice simple future past tense. Example. Once Anita's history books was going to be burned by Linda at school. Mean Anita's history book was not going to be burned by Linda at school. Was Anita's history book going to be burned by Linda at school? My old motorcycle would be by Bob the next day. Means my old motorcycle would not be by Bob the next day. Would my old motorcycle by book by Bob the next day? Next. Passive verb tense, simple past future. Passive verb tense in English can be formed various verb tense, including the simple past and future tense. Here are examples of passive voice sentence in both the simple past and future tense. Simple past passive. The book was read by Mary. Past simple passive. The letter was written by John. Past simple passive. In these examples, the action reading and writing was performed in the past, and the passive voice in creating by using the past tense of the verb be, was, or were, and the past participle of the main verb. Next. Number two, future passive. The cake will be baked by the chef. Future simple passive. The report will be submitted by the team. Future simple passive. In these examples, the action baking and submitting will take place in the take future and the passive voice in format by using all the future tense of the verb be, will be, and the past participle of the main verb. The passive voice is used to emphasize the action or the receiver of the action rather than the doer. In passive voice construction, the subject of the sentence receives the action, while the again the doer of the action is often mentioned using by or omits if it's not relevant or Okay, noun. Next. Okay, next. Maria.
Conclusion, future, and past future. In English, future and past future verb tense are used the express action or even relative to a particular point in time. Future tense, when the future tense is used to talk about action or event that will happen after the current moment. Two, it's a format by using auxiliary verb such as will or shall, followed by the base form of the main verb. Three, for example, I will go to store tomorrow. Next. Past future, future in the past. The past future, also known as the future in the past, I used to discuss action or events in the past that were considered a future from that past perspective. Two is the typically. Tunggu Handi, belum Handi.
Sabar Hamdi.
Handi nih Handi.
For using would, was, going to, or the other past form of modal verbs to express a future action from a point in the past. Three, for example, he said he will call me later, or he knew he was going to visit his grandmother last weekend. But past future or past future conditional. Sometimes past future can also refer to the past conditional, which is used to describe hypothetical action of event in the past that didn't actually occur. Two is the former using will have or could have, followed by the past participle of verb. And last, for example, I would have helped you if I had known. Next.
Next, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for your attention for my presentation. And see you soon.
All right. Do both of you have any exercise or practice for your friend? Oh, question dulu. Okay, any question?
Yes. Do you have any question, Al?
I think your explanation is quite clear ya. Kalau Miss yang nilai ya udah cukup jelas. Cuman nggak tahu nih teman-temannya ada pertanyaan nggak?
Oh, Miss sudah jelas. Alhamdulillah.
Ya jelas bagi saya karena memang saya paham materinya ya. What about your friend?
Tanyaan.
Hey guys, do you have any question?
Remember, pahami konsepnya, bukan hafalkan rumusnya ya, guys. Do you have any questions? Ada 14 orang yang join di Zoom ini. Apakah ada yang mau ditanyakan buat dua presenters kita yang begitu kompaknya? Saking kompaknya ribut terus dari tadi.
Slide-nya tertutup nih, geser deh, Miss, dia di
Tergeser sendiri, Maria, ya. Jadi jangan marahin kami, ya.
Gak tau Marianya ngeditnya caknya mis.
Any questions? If they don't have any questions, you, both of you, give them questions.
Andi, Miss.
Hamdi, Miss. Mulai deh saling lempar ya.
Kenapa aku ini?
Jawaban.
Kayaknya nggak ada yang bertanya, Miss. Mereka udah ngerti semua.
Ya makanya karena mereka udah ngerti semua, kalian yang kasih pertanyaan buat mereka, suruh mereka
Bertanya.
jawab. Oh, Miss
Maria,
aja. Nah.
boleh boleh Miss atau Miss ngasih jawab pertanyaan?
Enggak, Miss, nggak usah kasih pertanyaan. Kita konsep-konsepan aja ya. Alright, siapa yang bisa merubah kalimat ini? Ah, apa ya yang bagus ya? Okay. First question. Yang bisa jawab plus 1 point. Raise your hand first, jangan langsung jawab. Ya. Tensisnya ini tensis apa? Kalau nggak ada yang bisa ya udah. Nggak ada yang plus 1 point, ya nggak? No one? Yang presentasi juga boleh kalau mau jawab. Lumayan kan
Witness.
banyak plus teman-teman.
Witness.
Ya Allah, masih harus nyari dulu? Oh, belum dapat konsepnya berarti kalian ini.
Langsung dijawab ya, Miss.
Raise your hand, terus Miss akan sebutkan namanya, baru kalian jawab. Kita ada fitur raise hand kan kalau di Facebook lagi. Apa kita nih lagi ngapain? Lagi nge-zoom ya?
Rubis.
Miss, saya bisa Miss jawab, Miss. Insya Allah.
Oke.
Semoga. Coba
Oke.
dicoba, dicoba.
Ya, Hamdi. Tensisnya apa, Hamdi?
Tensesnya future tense, future tense. Eh,
Simple future tense enggak
the
sih?
sentence you provide is in the future tense.
Future tense, Hamdi.
Future, future, future
Futer,
tense.
futer. Oh, futer, futer. Alright, future tense. Or
Future
kayak Maria
tense.
bilang tadi ya, simple future
Simple
tense.
future tense.
Alright. Good job. Okay.
1 point, Miss.
Yeah.
Thanks, Miss.
Next, siapa yang bisa merubah kalimat ini menjadi kalimat pasif?
Pasif.
Saya
Ya.
Miss.
Siapa? Jonan. Oke, Jonan.
Iya Miss. Saya Miss. Nggak ada angkat tangan di sini Miss.
Nggak ada. Oh, di Zoom kalian nggak bisa angkat tangan ya? Oh, kasihan sekali. Oke, nggak apa-apa.
Udah update Miss.
Ya,
Oke.
Jonan. Gimana kalimatnya? Saya bantu ketikkan di sini.
Wait ya, Miss. The president. The president. Word, 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 word. Word, verb, word, wait a minute. Verb tiganya give apa ya, Miss?
Given.
Give,
Given.
give, give. Given, given. Bicycle to smart kids on the next event, Miss. To smart kids on the next event, Miss.
On the next event. Oke, ini jawaban Jonan. Ada lagi yang mau coba?
Handi, Miss,
Terus
lagi, Miss. Boleh, Miss.
bisa,
Boleh.
Miss, bisa.
Miss. Handi,
Oke,
Miss.
Nisa dulu. Nisa dulu, Hamdi. Hamdi kan ini materi kamu, ya jelas lah kamu bisa. Oke, Nisa. Kalau kamu
Bisa
sama
ya,
Maria
Miss.
nggak bisa, baru Miss mau marahin. Oke, Nisa.
Ya, ini Miss. Bicycles. Ada S-nya, Miss.
Okay.
Bicycles will be given to smart kids
Okay.
by the president at the next event.
Okay. All right.
Itu add bukan on.
Oke, walaupun soalnya on ya, kamu mau ngubah jadi add, nggak apa-apa, monggo. Ada lagi? Ada lagi yang mau coba? Oke, nggak ada ya. Alright, dua yang udah mencoba masing-masing plus 1 point. Yang benar nanti plus 1 point lagi. Oke. Remember bahwa Miss minta tadi kalian itu untuk merubah kalimat yang ini. Oh, kok nggak muncul? Oh, warnanya putih. Miss minta kalian merubah kalimat yang ini tadi ya. Ini. Yang pertama ini, yang the president will give bicycle to smart kids on the next event menjadi kalimat dengan polanya pasif. Ini ada di simple future, berarti remember kalau pasifnya simple future, kata kerjanya tetap akan dalam simple future. Ciri khas dari pasif adalah mendapatkan kata kerja bentuk ketiga. Makanya Miss bilang, ingat konsepnya. Kalau yang dibilang sama apa namanya Jonan tadi, would ini adalah kata kerja untuk tenses apa?
Simple future past tense, ya, Miss.
Okay, untuk past future. Untuk past future, karena di sini subjeknya masih the president, maka ini kalimatnya masih aktif, yang berarti ininya harus dalam bentuk pertama. Jadi the president would give bicycle to smart kids on the next event. Ini kalau dia dalam bentuk past future. Kalau dia misalkan dia mau dibikin pasifnya simple past future, gimana? The president would, eh kok the president lagi? Bicycles, ya, would be given by the presidentnya dulu boleh, atau kayak yang dijawab Nisa tadi juga boleh, to smart kids on the next event, ya. Jadi pahami konsepnya bahwa konsep future itu diikuti shall will, kalau past future itu should would, begitu juga pasifnya. Hal yang sama kalau kita pakai to be going to. Kalau to be going to untuk future itu am is are going to. Kalau untuk past future was were going to. Ya. Yang berarti kalau untuk pasifnya the president aktifnya itu the president is going to give bicycle to smart kids on the next event. Kalau untuk pasifnya bicycle apa? Gimana? Gimana, ayo? Misalkan Miss pakai to be going to. The president is going to give the bicycles. Bicycles to a smart kid on the next event. Okay. Gimana mau ngepasifkannya, Maria?
Ini the president
The president
is
masih pakai the president
the president
pasif ya.
who
Pasif, pasif, pasif.
will be
Kok beda? Belum sampai 10
Presiden
menit.
Will me? Will.
Will? Enggak, kita lagi bahas pakai to be going to. Bukan pakai will. Tadi kan kalimatnya the president will give the bicycle to smart kid on the next event. Ini sekarang kita pakai going to. The president is going to give the bicycle to a smart kid on the next event. Kalau dipasifkan,
Dari tadi.
kalau dipasifkan,
mungkin Handi bisa, Miss.
Hamdi boleh.
Mungkin dicoba ya. Bicycles.
Okay. The bicycles.
Bicycles are going to be
are
are going
going
to be
be
given to
okay, given to
smart kids to smart Anya udah usah misalnya.
Oh ya udah boleh. Ubah aja semau kalian ya. Awas aja nanti kalau UTS ya diubah-ubah
Boleh,
sendiri kalian.
boleh Anya, boleh Anya, boleh, boleh.
Lagian ini
Sorry.
di
Oh iya,
tugasnya
ada Anya.
di
Ada
tugasnya
Anya.
malah nggak ada S nih, the bicycle bukan the bicycles.
Yeah, the bicycle. Smart kids. To a smart kids. By the president.
By a
Smart
president.
kids. Yeah. By the president, at the next event.
Okay. Suka-suka kalian lah ya. Okay. Perhatikan ya penggunaan subjeknya. Kita punya subject verb agreement. Kalau seandainya sepedanya banyak, okay, kalian pakai are. Tapi kalau sepedanya cuma satu, is going to be given to a smart kid, bla 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 bla. Selanjutnya, oke. Jangan lupa subject verb agreement ya, karena untuk tenses itu subject verb agreement itu amat sangat penting. Kalau kalian keliru, ya udah salah. Jadi kalau subjeknya tunggal, dia verbnya yang mana? Kalau subjeknya jamak, dia verbnya yang mana? Be careful. Ya, hati-hati. Karena sekecil apapun penggunaan to be, kalau salah ya salah kalimatnya. Any questions? Ada lagi yang mau ditanyakan? Miss harap kalian, khususnya untuk yang presentasi, bukan cuman sekedar presentasi ya, but you have to know the concept. Kayak yang Miss waktu awal kalian kasih kalian table of tenses itu tahu dulu konsepnya. Kalau continuous konsepnya adalah dia verbnya pakai verb ing. Kalau pasif dia pakai kata kerja bentuk ketiga. Kalau present dia pakai kata kerja bentuk keberapa. Kalau past dia pakai kata kerja bentuk keberapa. Jadi kalian tuh pahami konsepnya. Kalau kalian mau menghafal, mungkin bisa kalian menghafal 16 nama tenses plus 3 rumus aktif untuk masing-masing tenses, yang berarti kalian harus menghafal 48 rumus kalimat aktif, kemudian 48 rumus kalimat pasif, mungkin kalian bisa menghafalkannya. Cuman apakah akan hafalan kalian itu bertahan lama? I don't think so. Jadi bukan dihafal, tapi pahami konsepnya. Ketika kalian paham konsepnya, kalian akan apa sih namanya tuh, bisa untuk menjabarkan rumus-rumus itu tanpa kalian perlu hafal. Ya, cukup jelas? Nah, untuk saat ini kan kalian masing-masing dapat jatah dua nih tensisnya. Itu pun cuman untuk bagian tertentu aja. Nah, pahamin dulu konsepnya untuk masing-masing tenses yang kalian pegang. Aktifnya gimana, pasifnya gimana. Jadi nanti kalian tinggal mempelajari dari yang dipresentasiin sama teman-temannya. Come on, kalian udah semester 3. Mestinya udah nggak harus disuruh apal-apal-apalin lagi. Ya, jadi kalian sudah harus mulai dengan memahami konsep. Oke? Any questions?
No,
Kalau nggak ada
Miss.
pertanyaan, Maria sama Hamdi, close your presentation first.
Maria.
Thank you. Thank you for attention my presentation. Good morning, and good morning.
Oke,
Selamat
good
pagi.
morning. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alright, thank you Hamdi and Maria. Ya, well done untuk presentasinya juga. Walaupun Miss lihatnya kalian itu masih menghafal, bukan memahami konsep, tapi kayaknya Hamdi udah mulai agak paham tuh tadi, paling enggak ya. Oke, yang lain ingat ya. I want you to understanding the concept, to understand the concept, not memorizing, ya, not memorize. Jadi pahami konsep, jangan hafal. Oke? Any questions? Untuk Faira sama Apla mau bayar hutangnya sekarang atau nanti pada saat tatap muka? Sinyal kalian aman nggak?
Faira aman, Miss. Top lah.
Gak tahu, aman sih dari tadi. Tapi gak tahu juga.
Apa kalau lagi nggak presentasi dia aman tuh. Coba aja kalau
Iya,
disuruh
kenapa?
presentasi, mulai tinggalnya gangguan. Ya udahlah, Apla sama Faira nanti pas ketemu lagi minggu depan ya, kan kita tatap muka ya. Berarti minggu depan pas tatap muka, Apla sama Faira dulu lanjutin yang pasif, kemudian kita punya siapa? Setelahnya kita ada Farah sama Evin ya.
Ya,
Kita udah
Miss.
mulai masuk ke progresif. Nah, udah mulai masuk ke progresif. Nah, Epin, ingat, progresif itu cirinya apa? Progresif itu adalah verb ing. Nah, gimana pada saat pasifnya? Pasif kan cirinya verb tiga. Kalau dia ada verb ing, ada verb tiga, gimana kalian bikin rumusnya? Berarti kan harus pakai apa? Gitu. Pahami dulu konsepnya. Oke? Okay? Oke?
Oke, Miss.
Okay? Any
Oke, Miss.
questions?
Enough, Miss.
Enough ya.
Miss.
Kalau nggak ada, bisa saya cukup ya untuk hari ini. Nanti kita ketemu lagi nanti minggu depan. Thank you for today. See you next meeting. Goodbye and Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you,
Cepat sembuh, Miss. Cepat sembuh,
Oke,
Miss.
thank you.
Thank you, Miss.